ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
Hi. Hi, everybody. Welcome. Welcome to Los Angeles, California. Welcome to the Late Late Show. I am your host, TV's Craig Ferguson. All right, all right, all right. No. You'll get your money. Sit down. We have a lovely studio audience tonight. Good Lord, what a lovely studio audience. And may I say, you at home too are looking very well. It would help if you'd put your pants on, but I don't care. You too, ladies. I don't even know what I'm saying. It is a great day for America, everybody. It's a great day for John McCain. He pretty much wrapped up the Republican nomination last night. He had victories in several more primaries. Now, people say that McCain is too old to be the president, but I think he showed a lot of energy last night. Do we have a clip of John McCain at the victory party? Yeah? Yeah, that's right. Start quaking, Al-Qaeda. Start quaking. Oh, my goodness, look at the window. Yes, exactly. Now, you know who said that he's McCain's... Rush Limbaugh said that he is John McCain's most valuable asset. That's what he said. That's a very big asset to have. Rush Limbaugh might be the biggest asset in the world. It's also over in New York. It's very, very cold. Big winter storm over there. How cold is it, Craig? Well, I'll tell you how cold it is, imaginary sidekick. Donald Trump is taking precautions. He's wearing 3 toupees. That's how cold it is. Oh, that's cold, Craig. I know. It's a terrible day for me. I have to be honest. I had the sniffles, then we had a flu warning. It's turned into full-blown flu. I've got flu. Do we have the graphic? Yeah, no. Flu storm. Yeah, it's horrible. Well, that's done it, hasn't it? That's underlined the deadly seriousness of my condition. The good news is, today I started, and now this is not going to be news to anybody who's been watching for more than 30 seconds, I started on the medication today. Prescription medication, you're looking at it. Whoa! That's right, imaginary sidekick, who I can now really see. It is, though, we get the flu storm, but now it's Rise of the Meds. Let's have another grab of Rise of the Meds. Oh, right. Awesome! Take that, flu. I'll push on through. George Lucas is like, these guys are so good, I feel such a fool. After Star Wars, oh, Jar Jar Binks and all that, look what these guys are doing with nothing. Anyway, my flu isn't important to the rest of the country, of course. Not right now. Not right now when America is in the middle of a heated contest. Yesterday, no one could figure out the front runner, but after last night's results, we clearly have a winner. That's right. Uno the Beagle won the Westminster Dog Show, everybody. Look at it. Uno the Beagle wins Westminster. That's right. Uno the Beagle. I predicted it here. You said, Craig, you're crazy. It can't be Uno. I said, yes, I can. And I've said it 100 times on this show. I love dogs. And if you don't love dogs, you go and join Al-Qaeda, you un-American bastard. Get out. I love dogs. You know what, I really love talking about dog shows because CBS can't stop me from saying the word bitch. This is awesome. Now, if only the Westminster people had a show for roosters. There's a kid in the third row going, I don't get it. What the hell? Anyway, the Westminster Dog Show, of course, is a granddaddy of them all. It's the Oscars for dogs. It's just like the Oscars, really, literally, except the speeches are shorter and slightly less butt-sniffing at the wet. It's more like American Idol, the Westminster Dog Show. But if Randy Jackson was on a dog show, then he would have to call everyone people. That wouldn't be. What people? It wouldn't be a bad idea to have real dogs on the American Idol, though. Then they could understand what the hell Paula Abdul is saying. Slasher, bajazzer. I gotta get me whatever that is for my flu. That's what I need. Anyway, the Westminster Dog Show was on TV last night. Now, I thought it was on last week. I was watching it, and then I realized, no, I was just watching Sex and the City. But I was... Do not turn on me! Do not turn on me! Not now! I've become a citizen! I threw my lot in with you people! You can't turn on me! One year back. That's right. That's right, I won you back with my undying pledge of allegiance. Anyway, the dog show is what I'm talking about. That was on the USA Network last night. Now, apparently the wrestling fans were furious because it preempted WWE Raw. Sure, they sent emails into the network, put the wrestling back on. We're sick of this gay dog show. You think dog shows are gay? Yeah, they're gay! We'd rather watch shirtless, oiled-up men in tights rolling around the floor together. Much less gay. I can only assume you're all on medication as well. Anyway, winning the Westminster Dog Show is a really big deal. The winner last night got to eat, Uno, got to eat filet mignon and stay at a hotel, which is great. Although what they should give the dogs is the prize they really want, which is 10 minutes alone with Michael Vick. Sure, that's what they want. That's what they want. No.
Hey, Michael, who's the bitch now?
The dogs in the Westminster Dog Show are judged in different categories. This is what I think is fascinating. They've got all the different categories. There's eye shape, expression, and testicles. It's true. It is true. They actually squeeze their testicles. I think that's demeaning. Do you know what's even more demeaning? If you add sound effects. Take a look at this.
This is a versatile dog in the field. Gordon Sayer. Fun-loving
dog is
a
high-energy breed and require all. You know what I'm saying? Take that, quality programming. Do you know why they squeeze the dog's testicles? This is true. To see if they react. That's what I looked on the... Why do you squeeze the dog's testicles? To see if they react. You squeeze me down there, I'll react. I'll buy you dinner. Hell, I might marry you. I've done it before. All right, we have to take a break. We'll be right back with the email or some such. Welcome back. Welcome back, my naughty monkeys. Oh, I'm so sorry. I've got the flu tonight. In fact, just hang on a second. I'll be right with you. I just have to write a letter. I think I may have got the flu from this, actually. Bird flu. Look, just stop your nonsense. I'm trying to write my letter.
Dear mighty CBS Corporation, thank you so much for understanding that I am suffering from the flu and allowing me to do the show anyway and not to take the night off, which was the stupid idea I originally came up with. After all, I am an immigrant.
I'm writing a letter.
P.S. I know that you said I could have the night off, but it made me nervous when you said I could have the night off as long as I took every other night off for the rest of my life. Love TV's Craig Ferguson. Right, get that in the mail, just over here. Right. Now, I have to warn you before we go any further. Angela Kinsey, who was going to be our guest tonight, is not here tonight. Now, I'll tell you why. The reason is why is this. She is pregnant. And I called her today. I said, you can't come here. I have flu. I don't want you to be coming near me. And she said, okay. So she'll be here on Monday, which time it'll either be me or Drew Carey will be here. Either way, somebody healthy enough to interview Angela will be here. Now, what was I talking about before the break? Dogs. Yes, dogs. I like dogs, and I'm not so keen on cats. Everybody knows that. I like dogs that can do tricks. Because there used to be this dog in Britain, where I grew up, and he was on TV a lot, and he could speak. I know. But he could only say one word, which was sausages. It's true, he was very famous in Britain in the 1970s. Do we have the clip of that dog that said sausages?
Tell us what you have on a Thursday, Prince. Yeah,
what's your Skippy Prince?
Yeah.
What?
Yes, yes. Isn't that awesome? That's my childhood right there. Although I have to be honest, when I look at it now, it seems quite suspicious that the guy's going, Sharshard. I believed a lot of things back then, like a mighty corporation would give you the night off if you were deathly ill. And we don't have animals much on this show, really. Well, we had the Baldwins on, but they're... No, come on, they're cute. They think they're people. Once we had a ventriloquist on this show with a bulldog. He makes his dog talk. And the dog was, when we were shooting the show, the dog was very happy to be on the show. If you know what I mean. Excited. In a doggy way. How can I put this? He, and I emphasize the word he, was very excited. Yeah, that's how I can say it. Anyway, it drove the CBS censors crazy because they were like, one of the greatest moments of my life when I saw all these CBS censors pressed against the screen, looking, trying to make us, has that dog got up? Is it or is it not? And they made us pixelate it. Look at this, look, there it is. There's the dog there. It's the only time I've seen three executives watch this show, but they, they didn't know, the ventriloquist was even more excited to be here. But he had pants on, so that kind of negates the whole thing. Hey, let me just say, I'm excited to be here right now. No, I'm not. That's not true. That's just the flu medication. Or is it? Oh, we have to take a break? All right, we'll take a break. We'll be right back with the email, everybody. We'll be right back. Welcome back, my naughty monkeys. That's enough. You know what it says on the flu medication? I took the medication and I thought, well, I better look at the side effects just in case. After I took the medication, which is kind of my history with drugs, to be honest. Well, that was great. Now, what are the side effects? You don't even want to know. All right. So I look at the side effects for this flu medication. It says may cause erratic mood swings and mental behaviour. Well, I think we've proved that wrong. Hey! Oh, I've got a fever. No, seriously, I've got a fever. Call a doctor. I know. All right, then. Do we have time for an email? All right, then. Yeah.
Rudy Toot email. Yeah, Jack, baby. Tonight, two emails rocks with a twist. That's right, baby.
That's right, baby. Let's do the emails. All right. No. Don't.
This is from Leon in Placerville. Leon says, hey, Craig. Hey, Leon. He says, hey, Craig, what is your imaginary co-host's name? Now, two things we have to get straight here. One, he's not a co-host. He's a sidekick. I don't have an imaginary co-host. And if I did have an imaginary co-host, it would be a very hot girl. But it's not. It's an imaginary sidekick. And I wouldn't be stupid enough to give him a name. Davis. Isn't that right, Davis? Yeah! You're the man, Craig. That's right, Davis, I am. What did you do at the weekend? Well, I just hung around. No one really noticed me until the flu medication kicked in. No. I wonder, Hollywood being a union town, I wonder if I get two salaries for this. Come on, SAG, back me up on this. let's see. This is from... this is from Caroline in Pacifica in California. I've been in Pacifica, you know. It was for a wedding, but I actually had a good time. Well, it wasn't mine. Too much of the truth, you drug-addled fool. Okay. Caroline says, when you took your citizenship oath, you promised to use arms to defend the US. Can you shoot a gun? Is that what it meant? I thought it meant, you know, you use whatever weapons you have in your arsenal, like sarcasm and charm. Like when terrorists would come towards me, I'd be like, hey, hey! That's right. As soon as these un-American hordes start streaming across the borders, I'll be like, hey, hey, cheeky monkey. And they'll beat a retreat feeling foolish. All right, we'll take a break. We'll be right back with Michael Clarke Duncan, everybody.
Heard of a porno called Elevator Wiener Party?
No.
That's because I haven't made it yet. You in?
I don't want to do a porno with you.
I do.
Hey, Wimpy. I bet I can kill you with my bare hands.
I don't think so. I've been working out.
All right. Come on in, bare hands. His hands way bare.
I misunderstood.
Kill him. Hey, Twinkie, check it out. I think that is disgusting. But I'm not 100% sure. You want another look? That's definitely sick. Let me see it one more time. Oh, that's horrible. Where are you going to?
Nine.
How's Sandra?
She's good.
Good. That's nice.
Welcome back, everybody. I'll be all right. Must press on. Must try and be upbeat for show business reasons. Yes, part of me still is a little bit Dakota Fanning. Anyway, my first guest tonight, a very good friend of this show, a very talented actor. He's starring in Welcome Home, Roscoe Jenkins, which is in theatres now. Good Lord. Michael Clarke Duncan, everybody.
Hey,
you. You look sensational.
I'm kind of cool.
You look fantastic.
I'm glad. You know what? It's been too long for me and it you. Has, you know that, man.
Yeah,
come
what's happening? Where have you been?
Oh, congratulations first.
On what?
Being a citizen of the United States of America.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Yeah.
Now what's wrong with Scotland? Why didn't you... What's wrong with Scotland?
Nothing wrong with Scotland. I live here in America. I'm not declaring war on the Scottish people or anything like that.
But when you go back there and they say, what are you, man? Yeah. What are you going
to
say?
Well, first thing I'll say to them is, why are you using that ridiculous Pakistani accent?
That was a good one.
No, it was pretty good, actually.
Good.
Yeah,
I thought that was pretty good.
No, I don't know I don't know if they'll be bothered by it or not. I better not go back.
No, you should not. You better stay here.
Just in case. Yeah, yeah. You're an American.
You're sick tonight, man.
I am. I've got the flu medication.
You know what you have to learn how to do? You have to be more aggressive. You have to start saying, look, I'm sick.
Uh-huh.
I'm not coming in.
Well, I said that, and they said, fine, then don't ever.
Then don't. Right. You have to stand. You play that ace.
Yeah.
That's what you throw down. You live with it. What can they do? What are they going to do?
Throw me out of the job.
No. So? Tell them so. Just say so. Just say so. Just do your hand like they do it. So. That's all you got to do, man. You got to be more
aggressive.
You're
right. Good night, everybody.
Let's go. That's right. Get out of here, man.
Did you do that? Have you ever done that with a job? Have you ever said, right,
I worked when they finished cement on the sidewalks.
Yeah.
And a guy fired me one day.
What?
So I marched right through the wet cement. Gave everybody triple overtime. I went out with a bang.
Yeah.
You got to start. You said, worldwide pants, we are out of here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's terribly funny.
No, isn't
he?
No, we're out of here.
We're not. We're good. We're good. Everybody's fine. Knock it off. You know what I think is interesting in this movie?
What?
That you're doing this, you're doing that scene we just saw there,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And you used to be his bodyguard.
Yeah,
didn't you?
I used to work for Martin Lawrence.
That's weird. Is that weird when you go back? And
no, it's kind of cool now because he can't tell me what to do.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got a big trailer too and, you know, everything. But it was actually very funny because he remembered me from being his bodyguard. And he said I was the only person he wanted to play that role. So actually worked out perfectly.
That is very, very. No, you were a bodyguard. You did a lot of that kind of stuff before you became a movie star, didn't you?
Yeah, I love doing bodyguard work, man.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, do you get into fights and stuff like that? Really?
I did.
Right. No, I'm guessing.
I didn't. I could talk a person out and get him outside and... You know, little bitty guys you have problems with. Nobody your size.
But trust it. Me, I'm not going to attack you in any way, shape, or form.
Sure?
I'll use my weapons, sarcasm and charm.
Right. That's how you get a hit.
That's how you got here.
That's how you got here.
Tell me about the movie. What's it about?
Roscoe Jenkins, played by Martin Lawrence, he comes back home. And he's a big Hollywood star. He's a big Hollywood star now.
Like you, for example.
Yes, exactly. Oh, that's amazing.
When you go back home, is it similar to what happens in the movie?
No.
What happens then?
It's no fanfare. Nobody, you know, I don't get nothing. You know what the mayor gave me when I went back home? True story. Went back home to Chicago. First of all, they gave Tom Cruise a big plaque. Best actor. And I'm like, okay. Well, I know I'm getting something. I'm from Chicago.
Best actor?
Yeah, best actor. Actor in Chicago.
Is that like Chicago slang for craziest guy we've ever seen?
Probably.
Yeah,
but they still
right.
gave it to him.
All right, okay.
So I'm thinking, okay, I know the mayor, Mayor Daley, so I know I'm getting some. He has in my room when I come back a book of Chicago.
Oh, yeah.
A book, like if somebody gave you a book of Scotland.
Yeah, yeah.
Right. He's like,
been there.
You couldn't give me anything, a plaque or something to say, you know.
Well, what would you like your plaque to say? We'll get a plaque run over here.
Know,
I'm sure we can do it.
One of Chicago's finest actors or something.
All right,
you know
okay. What about Chicago's finest actor?
That too.
All right.
Chicago's finest.
What part of Chicago are you from?
South Side. Represent the South Side.
Right, okay. Is that a pleasant area?
No, okay. It is now.
It is now?
It is now, but when I was coming up, it wasn't very pleasant.
Right. Was it tough? Was it tough in the streets? Did you have to fight your way two-fisted all the way to Hollywood, where you became lactose intolerant and all kind of stuff like that?
You're real sick tonight, aren't you?
I'm very sick tonight.
Yeah, I can tell, man. No, actually, I got into a couple of fights. My mother kind of showed me how to defend myself. My sister was the brawler, though.
Right.
My sister was the one who could... take on anybody.
Yeah.
And I was kind of like, yeah, him.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know, it's him. And she would go beat him up.
Does she ever do any bodyguard work now, or does she?
No. No, not now.
Hey, did you watch the Westminster Dog Show? And if you did you enjoy the testicle squeezing?
I like Uno.
Uno's
cool. Yeah, I got two dogs at home.
You got two dogs?
Lucy and Matrix. A German Shepherd is Matrix, and a Rottweiler named Lucy.
I have a German Shepherd.
Do you? They're the coolest dogs.
Very, very farty.
Are you a dog?
Yeah.
You know what? I hate that. Because when people come over to the house, it's the dogs doing that, but you can't tell people that.
No, and also German shepherds, German, like to march during the night. You know?
That sort of thing, huh? You know what? That's true, though.
It is.
That's
Do you have anything else? Do you have any snakes or budgerigars?
I used to have a snake. What was it last week?
A budgerigar. It's like, kind of like a small parrot.
A budgerigar?
Yeah, I'm really pretty high right now.
Right, yeah, you are. Budgerigar.
Yeah, yeah.
No, I never heard of a budgerigar.
That's a real thing.
Or budgerigar. No, I never heard of...
Ask Davis. Davis will tell you. He's right.
I do have a chinchilla named Chucky, though. Chinchilla.
A chinchilla?
Chucky.
What's a chinchilla?
You know what they make the nice fur coats and stuff
you
out of?
You can't do that with your pets.
No, I don't. Don't get Peter started on me, okay? No, I don't. Chucky is cool.
Do you have any cats?
5 cats.
Oh, stop.
As Pinky.
All right.
Bunny, Snowflake, Whiskers, and Big Papa. Big Papa's a little overweight.
That surprises me somewhat. That you, well, I didn't have you down as a cat guy.
No, I love cats. I have cat all my life, man.
Right, but so you've 5 cats, 2 dogs, and a chinchilla.
Yes, and fish.
And fish?
Yeah.
Do you ever feed the fish to any of the other animals?
That was cool.
I told you. No.
I love my little animals.
All right, okay. What kind of fish do you have?
They're koi fish.
Koi? They're delicious. Michael, they're
what
tasting.
What kind of man are you?
I'm a man that enjoys a fish dinner, is what I am.
Don't be that way with my animal. I'm... No, my fish are nice.
All right. But your koi is a delicious fish.
No,
have you ever been to the restaurant Koi here in Beverly Hills?
Once.
Right.
They do not serve koi at Koi. Don't do that. Because I've only been there once and I'll never go back if that's what I think. Please don't put that in my mind.
All right. They don't serve koi. Have you ever been to the restaurant Chinchilla here in Ireland?
You'll make me upset. Chucky is nice. Right, Chucky right. is cool. No, leave no, Chucky no, alone.
No, it's all right.
Leave my
it's all right.
alone.
It's all right. What about that? Are you still at the yoga? Are you still doing the yoga stuff?
Yeah, you should take Bikram yoga.
Well, I like the yoga. What's the Bikram yoga? What's that?
It's the hot yoga. You're in the room and it's 100 degrees.
Yeah.
Really good for your joints and everything. Clears your mind up. You would not have that cold if you did more yoga.
Well, you know who was here last night? Susan Sarandon was here last night. She said,
beautiful.
You would not have the flu if you looked after yourself better. And I'm like, I look after myself fine.
You don't.
Come on.
You don't. I have yet to get sick.
I eat as much koi as I can get my hands on. I'm kidding. I don't. I would never eat a delicious koi.
I'm going to walk out of here.
No, I don't.
I'm the only guest you got tonight. You know I'm the only one. I'm the only guest tonight, okay? If I leave, the show shuts down.
All right.
Do not piss me off.
No. I don't mean to piss you off.
Don't piss me off.
Michael, so tell me about the movie.
Tell me about the movie. Listen to what I got to talk
all
about.
Right.
I want to talk about my movie
right now. Tell me about the damn movie.
You know what, matter of fact?
What?
I don't like your attitude, and I want to sit in that seat.
Oh, come on, man.
I want to sit in that seat. I can't sit in that seat. Now, I'm taking over.
All right.
Yeah, that's right.
All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a fun show tonight, and my first guest, he's a comedian straight out of Scotland, it's Craig Ferguson!
Hi, everybody. But interesting you should say that, Michael, because we have to take a break. We'll be right back with the North Mississippi All-Stars. We'll be right back, everybody. Welcome back. My next guests are a Grammy-nominated blues trio. They're here performing Shake from their new album, Hernando. Please welcome the North Mississippi All-Stars, everybody. North Mississippi All-Stars.
Down. Grandma taught baby girl how to shake 'em down. Oh, shake 'em down, Lord. Oh, shake 'em down. Oh, pimp on your pimp. Crazy about that thing. Lord, she shake it like she cut the pigeon wing. Cut the pigeon wing, Lord. Cut the pigeon wing. Cut the pigeon wing, Lord. Shake what your mama gave you. 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 The pearly gates begging for to pass. Girl, you gonna shake it like it's gonna save your ass. Gonna save your ass, girl. Gonna save your ass. Gonna save your ass, girl. Shake what your mama gave you. Shake what your mama gave you. Shake what your mama gave you. What your mama gave you. Ain't in the graveyard, angels on high. But we gon' keep a shaking in the by and by. In the by and by, Lord. In the by and by. In the by and by, Lord. Shake what your mama gave you. Shake what your mama gave you. Shake what your mama.
Welcome back. This next performer will be appearing at the Hollywood Improv Comedy Club on Valentine's Day. Please welcome the very funny Jan Davidson, everybody. Jan Davidson.
Oh, you guys are wonderful. I am so glad to be here. I had a little trouble finding childcare at the last minute, but I worked it out. Does anybody pick up their babysitters across the street from the Home Depot? This will be very short then. I'm a terrible mother, which is okay, because I think the more you screw up your children, the more interesting they'll be as adults. First thing in the morning, send them out to the school bus. Have a nice day, honey. Mommy loves you. Or do I? See you after school. That's fun. My kids are bigger and they're getting really tall. And sometimes when we're out together, people confuse us for sisters. And when that happens, needless to say, I am very flattered. My son, not so much. He's the oldest one, and he's been after me to explain the facts of life to him. So I said, buddy, I think you're old enough to know that Natalie was a heavyset Jewish one, and Trudy was black, and she would roller skate, and Blair was the bourgeoisie blonde, and Joe was from the wrong side of the tracks, but she liked to fix motorcycles, so she was Brady. And they hung around with people like Elle DeBarge and Jerry, the stand-up comedian with the cerebral palsy, and they all attended Eastland, and I don't know if they ever graduated, but they did open a muffin shop. And he seems satisfied with that. But Dad's gonna have to have the difference jokes talk. You know who I hate? My daughter. I'll tell you why. Because she is at that great age where she completes every statement that comes out of her mouth with the words, and so, yeah. And so, yeah. Sasha said I like Hillary Duff, and I didn't like Hillary Duff. And Sasha told everybody I like Hillary Duff, and I didn't like Hillary Duff. And Sasha said I wear my hair like Hillary Duff, and I didn't wear my hair like Hillary Duff. I wear my hair like Nicole Richie. And so, yeah. I'm gonna drown her in the tub and blame it on postpartum depression. I've also been networking with some lovely local underprivileged pregnant teens, and now I know where all the safe baby surrender sites are. So one day, some poor firefighters are gonna find a 12-year-old with an ill temper outside the firehouse. My mom doesn't want me anymore, so you guys gotta take care of me now. And so, yeah. Each year, she and I observe Bring Your Daughter to Work Day, which is excellent because I'm an actor slash comedian and I get to keep my daughter home from school and we sit by the phone. I think she feels empowered. We enrolled the kids in boarding school. That's not true, I'm lying. We just don't pick them up on time. It's all the same up here. They're in public, and we moved the family from Los Angeles, California to, from Boston, Massachusetts to Los Angeles, California. Blech. And even so, they're doing really well in school, and they're really involved with a lot of after-school clubs and a lot of after-school activities. She joined the Bloods, and he joined the Crips. I said, I hope this is what you want to do, because I'm not going to go put automatic weapons on Layway and have you quit in a month. Spend an arm and a leg in all your colors. You say, I want to do Irish step dancing. No way, G. I didn't move so much from my career as a comic, more from my daughter's career as a bulimic. So, you don't want to have to say what if. My husband and I are breaking up a marriage of 15 years. Not ours, other people's. We really like their apartment. We're really happy. We have the most lovely wedding photos. We have the most uniquely beautiful engagement portrait. Some people call it an engagement portrait, and some people call it an ultrasound. Thanks, you guys are great. I'm Jan Davidson.
John Davidson. Well, that's great, lovely, thank you. I'd like to thank my guests, Michael Clarke Duncan, the North Mississippi All-Stars, and the lovely John Davidson. Join me tomorrow night when I will be pretty sick as well, I think. Oh, it's a carrot time, we gotta go. Good night, everybody, good night.